Good morning, Joy Gospel Radio FM family. It is certainly a wonderful privilege to be with you this morning. Our devotion this morning is coming from a very familiar Psalms, Psalms 1, verses 1 and 2. Praise God. Let us go to the throne of grace on this morning. Mighty God, we honor you, we praise you, and we magnify you for who you are. Father God, more and more every day we're realizing and recognizing who you are in our lives, oh God. I ask on this morning that even as we come before you, God, that you will give us listening ears and hearing hearts, oh God, that will not only be hearers of your word, but oh God, we'll also be doers. I pray that this word will be applicable, and I pray that, oh God, we will incline our hearts to hear from you this morning. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, we pray. Amen. The devotion is entitled this morning, Where Are You Seated? Where are you seated? Psalms 1, verse 1 and 2 reads, Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Praise the Lord. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Amen. Where are you seated this morning, family? As we keep going along, as we press towards the mark for the price of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior, one thing we as children of God need to do is to do some decluttering of our lives. Just like we have entered into this time of spring season, so it is that we go through seasons. This is a season of reevaluation and decluttering, realizing what is most important. Hallelujah. As Mary and Martha was in the presence of Jesus, only one was really experiencing the presence. Mary, as Jesus pointed out, had chosen the better part. Luke 10, verse 42. Psalms 1, verse 1 says, We are told that the man that does not walk in the counsel or the way of the ungodly is blessed. Mary, many of us, as Christians, our lives are so cluttered and messy because of the things we have covenanted with persons who are not in the faith. We have joined forces with persons that are not walking the same walk, not speaking the same language, but because we want to be liked, we want to be in the know, we want to be accepted, we have covenant relationships with these people, and we don't realize that it is because of these agreements that we have made. Because one thing, when you say someone is a friend, it's a covenant relationship. Hallelujah. And sometimes we have to check, do an internal check as to, like, why is this person here? Like, what is the purpose of this person in my life? Am I supposed to lead them to Christ? I'm not talking about those persons that are Christians and you're friends with them. And yes, it might not be a perfect relationship, but the word of God said, know them that labor among you, especially those that be of the household of faith. Talking about those relationships where we have, because of the prestige or the influence that knowing that person brings, we have done some things that compromises our walk. We have done some things that put us in a position where we become very judgmental of each other and of the body of Christ. So this morning, God wants to know, where are you seated? Hallelujah. And when we're in these covenant relationships and we're not prospering, we're wondering why. Our spiritual lives need to be decluttered. We make a lot of noise about other persons' religious beliefs, but some of the practices that they engage in, believe it or not, comes from the principle of the Bible. And maybe if we adapt some of those principles, like find some time to put in some prayer. You know, we come up against those persons that they might pray every 3 hours and they turn their head to the sun or whatever their religious beliefs and criteria, but we don't even ask God for pardon, or we don't even wake up in the morning and thank God for waking us up. We don't even say, God, you are God. And as we go through the day, we put it in your hands. We don't even acknowledge him. We roll out of bed and we get our day started. And it's when we're driving in our car, we're like, oh yeah, good morning, God. We need to put some things into practice that is going to bring us to the next level. But God wants us to really check where we've been sitting, so that we can realize the things that we need to fix in our lives so that we can get to the next level. Because time is winding down. We have to realize that we are just pilgrims passing through this land. We are here. Some of us, we have set up shop, permanent shop. Like, we're not going anywhere but here. Praise God. We need to just keep our hearts clean, as the word says. It is out of the heart flows the issues of life. Proverbs 4, verse 23. Me personally, as a child of God, I can find so many things in my life that can give me the feeling of justification to be bitter. But one thing I've made a choice to do is trust God to work out every situation that I will face, or I will ever face, or what I'm facing today. Let God do the God things. You know, lately I've been saying that. Let God do the God things. The things that I cannot control, the things that is not in my purview, let God do the God things. As we notice, the signs of the times are everywhere. We need to hone in on our spiritual well-being. Make sure we are giving God free access to every area of our lives so nothing creeps up on us and takes us by surprise. Remember, nothing takes God by surprise. We are the ones that are constrained by time. We are constrained by the elements of this world. God sits outside time. God sits on the elements. God is the one that is in control. Nothing takes God by surprise on this morning. Praise God. Let us choose wisely who we are in covenant relationships with, and making sure we are not being stumbling blocks to those that we have in our immediate environment and our inner circle. Sometimes the persons in our inner circle, we have done so many things to them, and we haven't even realized that we're not being the best Christian, the best friend, the best person that we can be to those people. But we will make a special attempt. We will go out of our way to try to be a quote-unquote good Christian to those that we might meet once. We will never see again. You will not make an impression on them, because they're going to see you just in passing and they're going to keep it moving. But the ones that we see on a daily basis, we don't take the time out to nurture the relationship, to see what we can deposit into each other. I remember one time I had a conversation with Sister Angela, and she was saying that, you know, one thing we should always try is, like, whenever you're in a conversation with someone, when you leave that conversation, you should leave feeling that you have deposited or you have received something from that person. So there is a purpose to you conversing with that person. Amen. Praise God. Where are you seated this morning? Where am I sitting? We tend to choose seats that will give us the best vantage point to see what is going on. But God is telling us this morning, let me be the usher of your life. Let me usher you to your seat. Sometimes when God chooses our seat, it's not the most comfortable seat. You see, we want the comforts of life. We want to be comfortable in everything we do. But God is about provoking us out of our comfort zone, provoking us to the next level, provoking us to walk in our purpose, provoking us to be our best self. Amen. Let God be the usher of our lives. Let him usher us to our seats, wherever he wants us to be. Because you know what? When we choose our seats, we tend to stay there a little longer than we need to. When God ushers you to your seat, he gives you, okay, this is your seat, and you have certain amount of time, and then you got to move on to the next event, the next seating. Praise God. We don't want to get stuck in a place where we should have left a while ago. God is not a stagnant God. God is a God about moving on, moving up, and getting us to a place of purpose and destiny. Let me choose where you should be seated, say God, this morning. Let me choose your seating. Man's seating choices are made by man's failed criteria. Man's choice has the ability to be done from a place of an imperfection. But God, who tries the heart of man, will make a seating choice for you that will bring you to your expected end. Praise God. Jeremiah 29:11 tells us that the Lord knows the plans he has for us, plans of good and not of disaster, to give you a future and a hope. Where are you seated this morning? Let God be the usher. Let him usher you to your seating, to your next seating. We don't want to be in a seating place where, yes, we might have a good view of what is going on. And I learned this word. We love the wahala. We love the drama. We love to be in the mix of things when God is saying, be still. Close your mouth. Some of us as Christians, we think we need to be involved in everything. We need to give an opinion about everything. When God is saying, be still, be quiet, listen, be slow to speak, quick to listen. But we don't like to practice that because we want to be heard. Let God usher us to our seat on this morning. Where are you seated? Hallelujah. We want to be seated in high places with Christ Jesus. Ah, our intercessor, our mediator, our Abba. We want to be seated where he's seated. So we always hear from him and we know his voice on this morning. Sometimes when you're seated in a certain place because of all the noise, you cannot hear the instructions of the commander in chief on this morning. Where are you seated? Praise God. Father God, we give you thanks this morning for your word. We honor you for who you are. Sometimes, God, when you're speaking, it's not comfort words that you give, but you give us words that will bring us to our next level, to help us to check ourselves, to help us to do what you need us to do to get to our expected end. I pray this morning you continue to touch our hearing, our hearts, our minds, our spirit, so we can hear what the Spirit is saying unto us. Father God, you said in your word, he that had ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto us. Help us not to sit in the seat of the scornful, O God. Help us not to be judgmental, O God, but help us to yield ourselves to you so that you can, O God, lead us where we ought to go and what we ought to do. Help us to give you free access to be the usher so that you can usher us to our seat. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.